Hey, Mount Juliet, what are your plans for the future? Your hopes, your dreams? On Thursday, March 18th, Mount Juliet High School will host a career day for students to dress as you see yourself in 5 to 10 years. Lab coats or scrubs, military uniforms, ballerina outfits, firefighter turnout gear, even steel-toed boots. Teachers, you are included too. We like to include everybody in this. Dress up from a previous career or what you may have chosen to be if you were not a teacher or a profession that you've always dreamed about. We hope everyone is included on our career day on March 18th.
Tomorrow is the ACT. Sophomores and juniors, make sure to show up to class prepared at 8:45 with a snack. Freshmen and seniors, tomorrow will be an asynchronous day for you. The Lady Bears softball team will be playing Green Hill tomorrow. JV will play at 4:30 and varsity at 6. Come out and support our team, MJ. Our baseball team is playing Battleground Academy at home tonight at 6. It's the first game of the season, so you don't want to miss it. Tickets are on gofan.co. To get you excited, Myra Pone made a hype video about it. Check it out.
What's up, Mount Juliet High School? This is Officer Gray and Officer Tuggle. This week, March 22nd through the 28th, is National Drug and Alcohol Facts Week. So each day during BNN, we're going to take a couple minutes to share with you guys some facts about drugs and alcohol abuse and help you make informed and safe decisions. So the first one's opiates, or opioids, and we're talking about prescription pills and heroin, which are, honestly, the prescription pills are it's a modern-day plague. I mean, I think it's probably one of the more available, I guess would be the most available drugs to teens because of the rate of prescriptions that are being pumped out and how dangerous they are. They're so highly addictive and what they do to the receptors in your brain and how, especially in young adults and teens, you know, your brain's still developing. And all of a sudden you start messing with those receptors in your brain and your brain can't fire the right signals off. And opioids are a depressant. And so it's, you know, you're bringing yourself down. And when you do that so much, your brain can never recover. So it's so hard to get yourself back up. So then we're seeing into rises in depression, rises in suicide, suicidal overdoses. And those are things that are we're really seeing. And it's really prevalent in teens, whether it's prescribed to them or it's prescribed to their parents or they're obtaining them illegally on the street. We see that this is it's a national epidemic. And I think the thing that's so worrisome about opioids is that, you know, the pill is so small, but yet they've become increasingly powerful. Whereas nowadays, if you get a hold of the wrong prescription painkiller and you take it, you can die instantly. I mean, there's nothing we can do to save you. Once that enters your system, especially if we don't have things like Narcan available, right then and there, then it's going to be very hard.
Hey, guys, thanks for your time today. Anytime you want to come talk to us about any questions you have about drugs, alcohol, or just how your day's going, our door is always open. Feel free to stop by, even if it's just to say hi. Thanks. Thank you.